Okay. These are, even though, yeah, where to start on that? It's really hard to get into the safe area. But in some ways, it isn't. That's the dark zone tipping at me into my turn on its side for anybody to believe spatially that that is what it is. In there, there's multiple doors. Now, coming straight from the post office is right there. And it says, like, a base of operations. And then right there, it says, post office. Oh. You know, it's got a picture that almost looks like a bank or something like that. But, FICA or something. Some fiscal monetary thing. You know what that is. Let's see, FDA is like food, and don't know what that is. So now you come from here. Which a lot of people spatially always, I'm not sure what other people do. That's the inverse base of operations through the Russian consulate and the General Assembly building, which is going to be like our future base. So that's the current base, if that means, from their perspective, and the past base, which is right here, right there.
Yeah.
Oh. It's not the same. You go in the post office, you bump bust outside of the General Assembly, the UN building, and that means right there. Oh! And you're like, man, I'm gonna jump right across, smack into the dark zone. Now, this is the most non-immediate door from the post office in there, the base of operations, to the dark zone. It's the easiest one to teleport to, and probably the one that's most likely to have rogues by, because everybody else doesn't want to go through the effort of going somewhere else to get into the dark zone. It's the only door. Well, technically, no, that's not true. There's a checkpoint. There's a checkpoint. There's a checkpoint. I think there's a checkpoint as well. But that would take more effort to come through that door or go through that door than that checkpoint or checkpoint, which is the only door facing the base of operations in that means. Ah. So, if you probably want to avoid being rogued in that, at least in the intro, because somebody's going to be randomly doing so, and sometimes you'll see skulls and other things over here at that checkpoint. Not sure if I opened that yet. And so we're going to go to that safe house. Now we're on the post office side, the opposite side, or for some perspective, the front side. And there it's cropped. Which is the back side of the front side, that's the back. And then we're going to go into the back. And since there's limited resources on this side of it, then there should be limited roguing on that side of it too. I don't believe there's a supply crate near there either. Because it's the boring side. But the boring side will allow you to get into the dark zone without getting harassed. Oh. A lot of people know that, but the extra, like, 2 minutes it takes to get over there, type thing that means, is not that exciting. So I'm pretty sure there might be a supply crate, like, up near the dark zone, DZ9 or DZ7. Or the 6 reboot. But that's got, like, a lot of stuff there. You see? In at the dark zone. Can I pick one of the doors on that side? No one cares. Just no one. I'm not sure what server we should say that. It's just not much excitement on this side. Compared to the front side, Throwdown, you'd have to run all the way across the dark zone just to be part of it and take pot shots and all other types of things just to be involved with that. and that's ridiculous. But we wanted to be born, and we were.
See what? Warning. Readings indicate this area is contaminated.
We safely entered a boring area without being jumped. Just some advice to think of.
Leaving contaminated area.
So I'm pretty sure there's supply crate drops up around here. So that should give us free reign to just come in and do some other stuff. I unfortunately don't know all the darks on my memory. I don't even have a single road show in here. Okay. Well, that's a non-disturbed entry. Now from the dossier. Let's see. Clear 25 landmarks in the dark zone. Doesn't look like anybody's on. And there's no global event going on. Jump other people for gear. I'm not sure if I can get into this landmark or is it underground. So, definitely don't see an entry. I figured I'd clear a couple of these over time. I think the other dark zone's released. I don't need to pop any of that out. We got a landmark. Switch weapon holster that. Recycle that. I guess that's it. So another landmark. I'm go near an extraction point. It's kind of towards the center. And Yeah. Most likely, the further in we go, the more rogues are going to be there. They're going to think we're up to something or trying to poach their ground or something like that. It might cause mischief. But anyway, that's getting into the dark zone. You know, get a landmark. Just leave that. Picking it up and meeting it at the hump. Get it to extraction and try to call a chopper and stuff and then deal with it. The AI would be one thing, but the human players roguing would be another. Just not worth the time. Yes, to other people, because, well, it's the juice that they want.
Supply drops detected. Coordinates uploaded.
Okay, if it's just AI, I can pop one of these.
Area secure.
Yay. Alright, that one goes into your inventory without radiation contamination. Really, like, hot zone contamination. Not from radiation, but like, dollar green food equivalent. Tech has changed since then. I'm not sure if other YouTube users